back to that.
To me, it don't make sense for a nigga to want to claim something that they ain't did nothing for. It don't make sense at all.
Nah, I'm not gonna get mad because I'm gonna, you know, the nigga whoever claiming me in my way, I'm gonna smash it. I'm gonna keep it moving.
Bond vicinity. Nobody move.
I had seen Snoop when he was younger before I had lost contact with him. I had just seen him bagging on some broad on my street, and I was like laughing like, man, I was like, I'm gonna take this little nigga to a party. But then it was like I lost contact of man, I guess growing up, you know, my first time ever sitting. And then he was going to school called Wilson with my little cousin. My little cousin. And he had some girls that was gonna beat her up, right? So he happened to be over one of the homies house the morning when I called home. And I was like, what y'all doing? He was like, man, I'm over here with Snow. I said, I said, let me speak to that little dude because he get my little cousins beat up. I holler on the phone. I said, little homie, be home in about 30 more days, man. Look out for my little cousin, man. And I come holler at you as soon as I come home. So I go up there to Wilson. When I come home, I see Snoop at the hot dog stand there out of favor. It's hot. I said, I know that's got to be Snoop right there. And we started, you know, we got together and started, you know, kicking and laughing. And hollering and talking, like, you know, we start feeding off each other.
I used to love Wilson. I did a song with her.
You
I
did?
Love him so much. Yeah, my little hairstyle back in the day was like flat on the side and curly on the top. Niggas is mad because they shit wasn't fly.
Please believe that, yo. Please believe that, yo.
What up, big homie? The nigga was able to bust a suit back in the day.
You know,
a suit, a three-piece suit, and every average nigga could only bust a pair of, you know, jeans and a t-shirt. I was able to get in a suit with my hair, you know, on the side. You know, even Shug tried to make a comment about it. I look like, I heard him on some TV show talking about, what he say? This shit was funny to motherfucker too. He said my nigga Snoop was like kid and play or something. He was like the five heartbeats. I was like the five heartbeats before I got with Death Row. But it wasn't that. What it was, I was just a fly nigga and I knew I was fly. Just because I'm from the hood don't mean I had to dress like that. I was a fly nigga that knew how to expand early in the game to where before I was in the rap game, like having money and doing whatever I was doing, I still was able to make whatever I had look fly and presentable to where you would appreciate it from an upper level and not just a hood aspect because I had the hood locked.
Yeah, I'm the original, me and Snoop. Me and Snoop started Dog Pound together. It was the spot where we used to kick it at, where we used to lounge and stuff. And then when Daz was coming from Oklahoma, him and Corrupt hooked up and they turned Dog Pound into a rap group. Pop, yeah. I mean, when I first, like, Trey D was my first artist.
Okay.
So, I remember I played a song for Pac in New York just before he was with Death Row. We was up in the room. He first one hit me, Mo Wet Noise Juice, Crush Ice. We in the hotel, I'm like, man, you like this nigga right here, man? He was like, yeah, he tight. You know what I mean? I went back home and told Trey D, I'm like, yeah, nigga, I like Pac in your shit, nigga, he said, he tight, you know? You know, when Pac was cool. Yeah, real people.